Hello guys, in this video I'm going to show you how we can create AI bucket list app in MIT App Inventor. So click on the standard project and my project name is bucket list app. Okay, so as you can see here, that's our screen. So I'm going to use here one layout, and that one is vertical arrangement like this. I'm going to make this hidden with this fill parent like this. Okay, now I'm going to use here one user interface and one button here, then one text box like this. Okay, and I'm gonna make this, so I'm gonna use it one more button. So let me just design this button to just like add to my list, something like this. Background color, you can choose anything, font bold. And I'm gonna use your text box with this something 70%, and I'm gonna use the button with it also like 70%, like this. Okay, and I'm gonna make all this thing in a center, then horizontal also, and I'm gonna make this background color to the black. Cool. Now what I'm gonna do here, I'm gonna use here one more button to show my all dreams, okay, this done. Now I'm gonna use here one list view, so I can see my all bucket list dreams here in my list, this list. Done. Now what we need to do here, we need to use here implement the AI also. Okay, so let me just use one label to just determine, like, so I'm gonna use here one label, so just say here like my bucket list like this. Okay, and I'm gonna use here the text color to the white like this, to the at least 20, and make some space between this. So I'm gonna change the, I'm gonna use a label, and I'm gonna make the height of the label is around 5%, something done. Done. So now I'm gonna use here one the database, so we can store our data. Okay, so I'm gonna use here, let's store it. So I'm gonna use here cloud DB. Okay, and I'm gonna use here one more thing, user interface, the notifier. And I'm going to use one more experimental to the chatbot. Done. So that's our design part. Now let's go to the block. So as you can see here, that's the block. Okay, so let's, whenever someone click on the button one, okay, so we need to store the data. So cloud DB, as you can see here, the store value, the store value is this. We need to store the tag and the value we need to store. So we need to store the text box one dot text value. Okay, this. And the tag should be the same as the value. Done. Now we'll store the all data here. Now whenever someone click on the button two, so we need to fetch the all data. So it's simply just click on the cloud DB and you will find here get the value, so get tag list, this one. Done. And whenever we got the tag list, see, got the value, this one, or got a tag list, so we'll just add the list, this list, in the list view. So as you can see here, get list element here and the values. Done. So we'll, this will display the all values. Okay, now what we need to do here, whenever someone get a list, okay, and whenever someone click on the any dream, suppose someone says the London, so whenever someone click on the London, okay, or select the London from the list, so we'll display the information related to that place. Okay, and you can ask anything about that place. Okay, so that can help you to, you know, achieve your dreams, or, you know, you will find the information related to your bucket list. Okay, so how we can do this? So it's simple, like whenever someone select, it means list view dot after picking, so someone pick the any element, then we need to just chatbot as converse the question like this, and list view this one item dot selection, where is selection, this one item dot selection. Done. Now this will ask the question. We need to receive the answer. Okay, got response, so we'll display that response in the notifier. So you will see here the one notifier is that after is there one option is the notifier is so password, so progress. So let me just tell you, as you can see, so text dialog, just use this. And the message, I'll just display the response text. The title, I'm gonna use the list view dot selection like this. Okay. And whenever someone cancellation is true. Okay. Now whenever someone put the text. Okay. Whenever someone say something and whenever they click on okay. Okay. So what will happen here? Notify, and you will find here after text input. Okay. This after text input, I'll just again convert that question. Okay. Whatever the response is, then again get response. This will convert the question again. This will you know, once we receive the answer, so this will display here, and we need to use your condition control if logic if response is okay, response is not equal to the cancel. So where's cancel? I'm gonna use this text here and just this cancel. If the response is not equal to cancel, then this will convert the question. If it's a cancel, then this will do nothing. Okay, so that's the overall app that we have created. Okay, so if you have any doubt, you can ask me a comment. Please subscribe my channel, like this video, and share this video. Have a nice day. Be safe. Bye bye.